This has been an interesting discussion, and as you look through the LCCMR's recommendations, members, I have you look at where some of this money goes to, because really it seems like these appropriations start replacing or adding to other budgets that are already out there. The DNR, Bowser, we're funding the University of Minnesota on issues that, and especially as Senator Anderson brings up water issues. My goodness, I wish we could just fund some of these folks from the university, from DNR, to maybe travel to California and study water recycle and reuse, since we're doing that sort of thing in this bill. Again, and I'll remind members that I have my water recycle and reuse bill here that we can't seem to get any kind of overall support, though a lot of us support it, and we want to fund those things that are already done, that are proven for decades in other states, and yet we want to try things over and reinvent the wheel. And the A2 amendment actually takes out one specific thing in which a certain person is trying to reinvent the wheel. Members, what the A2 amendment does is actually removes the funding for the Will Steger Foundation. As Senator Anderson said, we do want the best environmental education. We do want the best science education. And to fund a partisan-driven foundation like the Will Steger Foundation seems to be a tragedy. Members, Will Steger is not a scientist, nor is he a qualified teacher. And so when we're looking at these education issues, we need to look at who's behind the scenes and why are we funding them under education. In fact, I hope members have been able to see his presentations. I think they're rather exhilarating, and actually they're kind of fun. But his presentations on climate change are not based on any science. Members, they're based on his thoughts and feelings as a Arctic explorer. There's no factual data in him, and in fact, you know, as a person that studied the climate change issue for the past 8 years and the science, I do find great humor in some of his presentations. My favorite example is his picture of the polar bear, and he shows you a dead polar bear, members, and says, this polar bear died of global warming. However, there's no autopsy, there's no other ways to prove that, and in fact, it's in direct opposition to the world's premier polar bear scientist, Dr. Mitchell Taylor, will tell you that, in fact, polar bears are not declining, and in most areas are so abundant that they actually cause a problem. Members, you can hunt polar bears for sport in Canada, in Greenland. There's not issues with polar bears. I find this extremely troubling to put money towards education for somebody that wants to be so partisan and biased in their education to children, to slant science in a way that has no proof and no verification. Yes, members, I am adamant about science education. I'm adamant about the environment. I am adamant about protecting our water resources. And I argue for it every day, and yet we want to fund people that want to do something else for some personal gain. When you think about this, it's actually going to be reviewed as well by the Union of Concerned Scientists. Well, members, maybe you ought to look at who belongs to the Union of Concerned Scientists, because I think it would be more aptly named the Union of Concerned Journalists. There's more journalists that are members here. There's very few scientists. There's a lot of people that are members of this organization, but it is not a scientific organization. We use these nice feel-good names to give our organization's credibility. We do not need the Union of Concerned Scientists reviewing something that our children see, because they don't have anything based in science. And lastly, members, the Will Steger Foundation gets continuing support from taxpayers. I believe last year was about 13%. And that some of that money, members, actually went to at least one person from our house to be able to take a trip. One of our house members got to take a trip to Copenhagen to the climate change conference on the Will Steger Foundation. And I don't think, members, we ought to be putting money towards things that probably fund some of our own people to do some nice travel around the world. It just doesn't seem like a good thing, and I hope you'll support me, members. I ask for a roll call.
This is education, members. And Will Steger's expertise is based not on his ability to get up and make a big speech, but on observation.
I'm glad Senator Anderson did say that his presentations are based on observation, because, as I said, members, they are observations. They are feelings about what he thinks is going on based on what he sees. There is no scientific proof to anything he puts in his observations. And quite honestly, I've seen his presentation many times, and I can tell you all the reasons for the things that are going on. There's a ton of scientific proof. I just wish if we're going to use that as an education tool, we would actually use the science and not base our education on feelings. Within the proposal, it says specifically that this proposal is in order to engage people in climate change solutions. So once again, if we're assuming that there's some climate change issues that we can fix, and we'd have to be assuming those since they would not correlate with actual scientific data, then that education that the Steger Foundation would be coming out with is geared towards that. So therefore, it would need to be based on sound science. And it is interesting, too, because I just have information here. Just came out last Monday, I believe. The Pew Research Center came out with a new poll, and it came to the same conclusion that the Copenhagen Consensus of Bjorn Lomborg came out with a number of years ago, members. Out of 21 social and economic issues, global warming ranks last as a top priority by Americans because, members, Americans are understanding the farce of man-made global warming. They get it, and we ought not to be funding anyone with any kind of dollars that go through the state or federal government to continue this farce.
You know, when you got like 99% of all the credible scientists in the world that say that, you know, there is something to this global warming or global climate change issue, then I think we should probably pay a bit of attention.
Thank you, Mr. President. I hate to keep going, but it seems that members never want to come and visit my office and actually see the documentation of which I keep and which exists all over. This isn't hard to find. So, Senator Murphy, I invite you to my office. I keep extensive files. I keep extensive research papers. I would be happy to show you, and I believe you could maybe go look at the Oregon petition, the tens of thousands of credible scientists that actually have background in climate and other issues that signed on to that petition.